Hi, and welcome to Good House 1968. What I do is I read and interpret from the Bible, the Holy Bible. I read and interpret from the Tanakh, which is the original version of the Bible. It's the version that the King James Version was interpreted from, or the Hebrew Bible. I'm going to begin with some commercial announcements, and then I'm going to go into the program. Looking to attend an academy, La Pete Academy, give them a call at 877-915-6850. Looking for an 800 number for your business? Call Ring Central, 877-590-6374. Looking to do some travel? Call Skylux Travel, 855-394-1552. In need of credit repair? Call Credit Repair at 888-855-3560. Looking to attend a university or an academy or college? Then call the National Education Center, 866-947-9784. Been injured in an automobile accident, a work injury accident? Call Stephacker Law Firm at 888-439-3370. Senior citizen facing foreclosure? Call Qualified Reverse Leads for a reverse mortgage, 877-288-3715. Need communications for your business? Call Jive Communications, 855-450-5337. Need software for your business? Call SOG Software, software designed for small business solutions, 855-980-3003. Looking for just general products or different products? Call Sales Nexus at 855-781-1788. All right, that is my announcement. And now we go into the book of Genesis chapter 5, and I'll begin to read and interpret. It goes to say, here's the genealogy of Adam. On the day that God created man, he made him in the likeness of God. He created them male and female. He blessed them and called them Adam, humankind, man, on the day they were created. After Adam lived 130 years, he fathered a son like himself and named him Sheth. After Sheth was born, Adam lived another 800 years and had both sons and daughters. In all, Adam lived 930 years, then he died. Sheth lived 105 years and fathered Enosh. After Enosh was born, Sheth lived another 807 years and had sons and daughters. In all, Sheth lived 912 years, then he died. Enosh lived 90 years and fathered Kenan. After Kenan was born, Enosh lived another 815 years, had sons and daughters. In all, Enosh lived 905 years, then he died. Kenan lived 70 years and fathered Methuselah. After Methuselah was born, Kenan lived another 840 years and had sons and daughters. In all, Kenan lived 910 years, then he died. Mahulahel lived 65 years and fathered Yared. After Yared was born, Mahulahel lived another 830 years and had sons and daughters. In all, Mahulahel lived 895 years, then he died. Yared lived 162 years and fathered Hanok. After Hanok was born, Yared 800 years and had sons and daughters. In all, Yared lived 962 years, then he died. Hanok lived 65 years and fathered Meshulech. After Meshulech was born, Henoch walked with God 300 years and had sons and daughters. In all, Henoch lived 365 years. Henoch walked with God, and then he wasn't there because God took him. Methuselah lived 187 years and fathered Lamech. After Lamech was born, Methuselah lived 782 years and had sons and daughters. In all, Methuselah lived 969 years, then he died. Lamech lived 182 years and fathered a son, whom he called Noah. Restful, for he said, "This one will comfort us in our labor and the hard work we do with our hands to get what comes from the ground, that Adonai or good curse." After Noah was born, Lamech lived 595 years and had sons and daughters. In all, Lamech lived 777 years, then he died. Noah was 500 years old, and Noah fathered Shem, Ham, and Japheth. So this goes to show us that man did have in him the inspiration to live forever from the ages of these brothers who are here, who were just announced, and their lifespans. He goes to say, in time when man began to multiply on earth, and daughters were born to them, the sons of God saw that the daughters of men were attractive, and they took wives for themselves, whomever they chose. Good said, "My spirit will not live in human beings forever, for they too are flesh, therefore their lifespan is to be 120 years. The Nephilim were on the earth in those days, and also afterwards, when the sons of God came into the daughters of men, and they bore children to them. These were the ancient heroes, men of renown. Good saw that the people of earth were very wicked, that all the imaginings of their hearts were always of evil only. Good regretted that he had made humankind on the earth. It grieved his heart. Good said, I will wipe out humankind whom I have created from the whole earth, and not only human beings, but animals, creeping things, birds in the air, for I regret that I ever made them." But Noah found grace in the sight of good. Here's the history of Noah. In his generation, Noah was a man righteous and wholehearted. Noah walked with God. Noah fathered three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. The earth was corrupt before God. The earth was filled with violence. God saw the earth, and yes, it was corrupt, for all living beings had corrupted their ways on the earth. God said to Noah, "The end of all living beings has come before me, for because of them the earth is filled with violence. I will destroy them along with the earth. Make yourself an ark of gopher wood. You are to make the ark with rooms and cover it with pitch both outside and inside." Here is how you are to build it. The length of the ark is to be 450, its width 75 feet, and its height 45 feet. You are to make an opening for daylight in the ark 18 inches below its roof. Put a door in its side and build it with lower, second, and third decks. Then I myself will bring the flood of water over the earth to destroy from under heaven every living thing that breathes. Everything on earth will be destroyed. But I will establish my covenant with you. You will come into the ark, you and your sons, your wife, your sons' wives with you. So this is good showing his grace to those who are righteous like he did to Noah. Good spared him because he was a righteous man, like he will do in the last days for those who are righteous, who are judged during the great tribulation as being righteous. So this is something we want to be proven as righteous in the last days before good on Judgment Day, the great tribulation, which is going on right now. It goes to say, from everything living, from each kind of living being, you are to bring two into the ark to keep them alive with you. They are to be male and female. Of each kind of bird, each kind of livestock, and each kind of animal creeping on the ground, two are to come to you, so that they can be kept alive. Also take from all the kinds of food that are eaten, and collect it for yourself. It is to be food for you and for them. This is what Noah did. He did all that God ordered him to do. God said to Noah, come into the ark, you and all your household, for I have seen that you alone in this generation are righteous before me. Of every clean animal you are to take seven couples, and of the animals that are not clean, one couple. Also of the birds in the air, take seven couples in order to preserve their species throughout the earth. For in seven more days I will cause it to rain on the earth, 40 days and 40 nights. I will wipe out every living thing that I have made from the face of the earth. Noah did all that God ordered him to do. So we see here that Noah was to take of every clean animal, seven couples, and of animals that are not clean, one couple. And of the birds, seven couples. So this was to preserve the species alive throughout the earth. So it wasn't like we always perceive, which is just one. He was supposed to take one male of each, a male and a female of each species. Noah was 600 years old when the water flooded the earth. Noah went into the ark with his sons, his wife, and his sons' wives because of the flood waters. Of clean animals, of animals that are not clean, of birds, and of everything that creep on the ground, couple male and female went into Noah in the ark, as God had ordered Noah. After 7 days, the water flooded the earth. On the 17th day of the second month of the year of the 600th year of Noah's life, all the fountains of the great deep were broken up, and the windows of the sky were open. It rained on the earth 40 days and 40 nights. On the same day, Noah entered the ark with Shem, Ham, Japheth, the sons of Noah. Noah's wife, the three wives of his sons, accompanying them. They and every animal of every species, all the livestock of every species, every animal that creeps on the ground of every species, and every bird of every species, all sorts of winged creatures. They went into Noah in the ark, coupled from every kind of living thing that breathes. Those that enter went in male and female from every kind of living being, as God had ordered them, and good shut him inside. The flood was 40 days on the earth. The water grew higher and floated the ark so that it was lifted up off the earth. The water overflowed the earth and grew deeper until the ark floated on the surface of the water. The water overpowered the earth mightily. All the high mountains under the entire sky were covered. The water covered the mountains by more than 22.5 feet. All living beings that moved on the earth perished, birds, livestock, other animals, insects, and every human being. Everything in whose nostril was the breath of the spirit of life, whatever was on the dry land, died. He wiped out every living thing on the surface of the ground, not only human beings, but livestock, creeping animals, and birds in the air. They were wiped out from the earth, only Noah was left, along with those who were with him in the ark. The water held power over the earth for 150 days. God remembered Noah, every living thing, and all the livestock with him in the ark. So God caused the wind to pass over the earth, and the water began to go down. Also the fountains of the deep and the windows of the sky were stopped. The rain from the sky was restrained, and the water came back from completely covering the earth. It was after 150 days that the water went down. And on the 7th day of the 7th month, the ark came to rest on the mountains of Ararat. The water kept going down until the 10th month. On the first day of the 10th month, the tops of the mountains were seen. After 40 days, Noah opened the window of the ark which he had built, and he sent out a raven, which flew back and forth until the water had dried up from the earth. Then he sent out a dove to see if the water had gone from the surface of the ground. But the dove found no place for her feet to rest, so she returned to him in the ark, because the water still covered the whole earth. He put out his hand, took her, and brought her into him in the ark. He waited another 7 days and again sent the dove out from the ark. The dove came in to him in the evening, and there in her mouth was a freshly plucked olive leaf. So Noah knew that the water had cleared from the earth. He waited yet another 7 days and sent out the dove, and she didn't return to him anymore. By the first day of the first month of the 601 year, the water had dried up from off the earth. So Noah removed the covering of the ark and looked, and yes, the surface of the ground was dry. It was on the 27th day of the second month that the earth was dry. God said to Noah, "Go out from the ark, you, your wife, your sons, and your sons' wives with you. Bring out with you every living thing you have with you, birds, livestock, every animal that creep on the earth, so that they can swarm on the earth, and be fruitful and multiply on the earth." So God still with his plan of being fruitful and multiplying on the earth, filling the earth. So Noah went out with his sons, his wife, and his sons' wives, every animal, every creeping thing, and every bird, whatever moves on the earth, according to their families, went out of the ark. Noah built an altar to God. Then he took from every clean animal and every clean bird, and he offered burnt offering on the altar. God smelled the sweet aroma, and God said in his heart, "I will never again curse the ground because of humankind, since the imaginations of a person's heart are evil from his youth. Nor will I ever again destroy all living things as I have done. So long as the earth exists, sowing time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night will not cease." He goes to say, God blessed Noah and his sons and said to them, "Be fruitful, multiply, and fill the earth. The fear and dread of you will be upon every wild animal, every bird in the air, every creature populating the ground, and all the flesh in the sea. They have been handed over to you. Every moving thing that lives will be food for you, just as I gave you the green plants before. So now I give you everything, only flesh with its life, which is its blood, you are not to eat." So you're not to eat the blood of the animals, the flesh with its life, which is its blood. "I will certainly demand an accounting for the blood of your lives." So God will take back for the blood that you for the life that you take in. "I will demand it from every animal and from every human being. I will demand from every human being and accounting for the life of his fellow human being. Whoever sheds human blood by a human being will his own blood be shed. For God made human beings in his image. And you people be fruitful, multiply, swarm on the earth, and multiply on it. So, from your fellow man, your blood, from the fellow man, your blood, from what you took in, God is asking for that life back from every human being and every living animal out there. So the blood that they ate, the food you eat, that you take in, he's asking back an account of that. God spoke to Noah and his sons with him. He said, "As for me, I am herewith establishing my covenant with you, with your descendants after you and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the livestock, and every wild animal with you, all going out of the ark, every animal on earth. I will establish my covenant with you that never again will all living beings be destroyed by the waters of a flood, and there will never again be a flood to destroy the earth. God added, here is a sign of the covenant I am making between myself and you, and every living creature with you for all generations to come. I am putting my rainbow in the cloud. It will be there as a sign of the covenant between myself and the earth. Whenever I bring clouds over the earth and rainbow is seen in the cloud, I will remember my covenant which is between myself and you and every living creature of any kind. And the water will never again become a flood to destroy all living beings. The rainbow will be in the cloud so that when I look at it, I will remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of any kind on the earth. God said to Noah, this is a sign of the covenant which I have established between myself and every living creature on the earth. The sons of Noah who went out from the ark were Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Ham is the father of Canaan. These three were the sons of Noah, and the whole earth was populated by them. Noah, a farmer, was the first to plant a vineyard. He drank so much of the wine that he got drunk and lay uncovered in his tent. Ham, the father of Canaan, saw his father shamefully exposed, went out and told his two brothers. Shem and Japheth took a cloak, put it over both their shoulder, and walking backward went in and covered their naked father. Their faces were turned away so that they did not see their father lying there shamefully exposed. When Noah awoke from his wine, he knew what his youngest son had done to him. He said, "Cursed be Canaan, who will be a servant of servants to his brothers." Then he said, "Blessed be God, the God of Shem, Canaan, will be their servant. May God enlarge Japheth, he will live in the tents of Shem, but Canaan will be their servant." After the flood, Noah lived 350 years. In all, Noah lived 950 years, then he died. Those are my readings for today. That is my lessons for today. So, I'm going to say a prayer for you guys, and then I'll be leaving you. The lesson we learned here in the ending is about shame, and that is you can be cursed for sinful act, because just as Canaan saw his father shame, he shouldn't have went and told his brothers and spoke about it. He should have covered him left out without looking at him. So this is something we want to remember today, even as we see our own fathers in their naked mothers, fathers and mothers in their nakedness and shame. We don't want to go out and laugh or make fun of them. We were to cover them and or to leave out of that room and close that room off. All right. Good, I petition you that you strengthen the brothers and sisters up. I pray that they take in accurate knowledge of the good news of the kingdom. I pray that they learn it in their hearts and that they meditate over it in their hearts and that they ponder and stay with the good news and learn it and practice what they learn. I pray that you strengthen them up and protect them from Satan's temptations and his demons' temptations. And I pray that you watch over and guide them. And I pray this in the name of Yeshua. Amen.